In this video, I'll show you lexicon formatting features like links to primary source text, reformatting lexicons, emphasizing active references, and much more. Let's imagine you're studying the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 5, and you come across the word blessed. To get a better understanding of the original Greek, right-click to show the context menu. Ensure the lemma or dictionary form of the word is selected on the left, and scan the lookup options. Lexicons addressing this word will show in the order you've prioritized them in your library. Click BDAG to open the standard Greek lexicon. BDAG is an essential tool for this kind of original language work, but working with such a comprehensive work can be daunting. So, Logos offers several formatting options to improve your experience. First, notice that Logos shows two basic definitions for makarios, marked by a black circle with a number inside. The editors provide extended definitions for each sense of the word in bolded text, and mark good working equivalents for the Greek word in translation in bold italics. With Logos, footnotes, abbreviations, primary source texts, and other connected entries are linked. Hover over abbreviations to see full meanings, like pertaining to or compare, frequently in reference to citations from ancient texts. You can also hover over citations to preview them, or click to open the source in a new panel. Let's view two other ways lexicon formatting aids your study. Logos can structure any lexicon entry to show a more organized format. Click on the visual filters icon and select outline formatting. The outline structure expands the entry visually, both organizing it and making it more useful and scannable. Because we're studying Matthew 5, it would be helpful to note if the editors cite the passage somewhere in this long entry. Instead of scanning through the text, open the visual filters again and select Emphasize Active References to immediately locate and highlight all the places Matthew 5 appears in this lexicon entry. Notice how Logos highlights Matthew 5 in the second definition, pertaining to being especially favored, under the first subsection of humans who are the privileged recipient of divine favor. These indicators help you spend the majority of your time analyzing the text rather than searching long entries for your passage. We arrived at this current entry by starting with a biblical text, but in Logos, you can also start with the lexicon to locate mentioned words in your text. Click the inline search icon and type Matthew 5, 1-11 to show everywhere BDAG references any verse in this range. The editors explicitly reference the passage 59 times in the entries. To view any entry in more context, change the displayed results to paragraph or article, or click any entry to open the full entry. Finally, whenever you study a particular word, your understanding can be sharpened by comparing and contrasting it with other similar words. Since the ESV translates makarios as blessed, let's see what other words share the same suggested gloss in this lexicon. Type blessed in the search bar and click all text to show the search filter options. I'll expand search fields and choose formal equivalent to find everywhere the English word blessed appears in the lexicon as a gloss. Logos deepens lexical studies by organizing the entries, surfacing the most important details for your current context, and by providing advanced searching tools for making new connections.